everyone to this second episode of our parish Lenten Retreat. During this episode, we will be building on our previous theme, that of recognizing God's presence in our everyday life. During this episode, we will be exploring on how we navigate our life. So during the episode, once again, there will be a talk, a story, an activity, a guided meditation, and of course, time for personal prayer and reflection. So to start with, each person watching today will once again need a pencil or a pen and paper. You will also need one candle and something to light it with. Once you have gathered all these items, find a quiet, peaceful, and comfortable place where you can spend the next 30 minutes comfortably and most importantly, without any distraction.
So as we begin, we invite you to take up your candle and light it. Place it somewhere visible as a symbol of God's presence with us now. So let us start with a prayer. And as the words come up on your screen, I invite you to say it with me. Good Lord, we thank you that we can come together spiritually in this moment to draw ever closer to you. In this time when fear, confusion, selfishness and pain have taken root in many lives, we ask for the strength to turn our face to you and the abundant life you offer us. May we be open here and now to all you have planned for our lives. We ask this through the Holy Spirit. Amen. Now take a moment to sit and be still. A quote will appear on your screen. Read it, or speak it, or listen to it, and see which words register with you. This is what the Lord says. Stand at the crossroads and look. Ask for the ancient paths. Ask where the good way is and walk in it. And you will find rest for your souls. The theme of this episode is navigating. Now that we've explored a little bit how we can come to recognize God's presence in our life, we want to look at how that has an impact on how we navigate through the experiences day to day. What landmarks and directions do we use as we journey on the great pilgrimage that is life towards our ultimate destination, the loving arms of our God? Often these days when we set out on a journey, we use a sat nav to tell us which direction to go in. But in life, what sat nav are we listening to? Are we listening to the directions God is offering us, or are we tuning in to something else? In this episode, we're going to explore how we can follow the directions the Lord is offering us so we can walk on the path that He wants us to follow. So let's hear a story now about some monks who navigated in a very interesting way. Right, passport check, ticket check, I'm off. Bon voyage.
Many people think that the first European to discover the Americas was Christopher Columbus. But many of us who live in Scotland or Ireland realize that many centuries before Columbus discovered America, Brendan, the navigator, had set sail and crossed the wild seas and visited even North America. And how did he do it? Brendan was a Celtic monk, and they were great travelers. They traveled from Ireland, crossed the wild seas to Scotland, travelled from Iona to Europe. Great voyages. But how did they travel over the seas? They travelled by coracle. I remember one summer I was visiting Iona, and I was shown a coracle, a real coracle. For the first time in my life, I'd often seen pictures of coracles. And I was invited to go for a sail in the coracle. But I was too frightened. The sea was wild, and this coracle seemed such a flimsy vessel. And yet, it was by coracle that the Celtic monks navigated their ways to so many parts of the world. They would set sail in their coracles. But how did they travel? How did they navigate? You remember, if you watched a river, the river is often broken by waves and eddies, in which the water seems to rush off in all directions and even against the main flow, while underneath all that is rushing along the surface of the water, there is a constant, steady current which can be felt more strongly below the surface where the water is deepened. Now, Brendan and the Celtic monks understood all about this. They would often set sail on their travels in their flimsy coracles, and in seeking the direction to go, they would crouch down on the bottom of the coracle and cup their ears to listen, and so discover the direction of the currents beneath them and the way they wish to go. Familiarity with that process and practice bred greater familiarity, and so they learned to be true and great navigators. Now, I think there's something quite profound that we can learn from these Celtic monks as we journey through life and we're blown in one direction and the next. There are things that disturb us in our daily lives. Where is our heart? What is our heart telling us? And like the Celtic monks, we really have to cup our ears and listen. Listen very, very deeply. We know how we're drawn in this direction and in that direction. We know at times we are deeply drawn to the Lord, and at other times we feel ourselves going in a different direction, or pulling away from Him. Learning from the Celtic monks, we also can become great navigators in life. Listening, listening, listening for the deeper currents in our hearts. What do we most deeply desire? Where is the Lord truly guiding us?
We are now going to show you a short video about a man who discovers a stethoscope on the street. This stethoscope gives him an interesting insight into the things and the sounds around him. First, I would like you to take a few moments to register how you feel after watching that video. Did it stir up any emotions within you? Did you identify with the video? You might like to pause this video and write down a few thoughts. Or you might just want to take a few moments to identify what's in your mind right now. For the next activity, we've allowed 15 minutes, but once again, if you'd like to take longer, feel free to do so. After I finish the explanation, just press pause on the video and play again when you're ready to come back. First, you will need the piece of paper and the pen that we asked you to have ready. On this piece of paper, we want you to draw a simple table with two columns. Something like this. Once you've drawn that, sit comfortably and cast your mind over your life. Just let your mind roam freely over the activities, the jobs, and the tasks that you undertake in your life, the relationships you have, with whom, what kind of relationships are those? Think over the things you consume, both physically, spiritually, materially. What do you spend your time doing? What do you spend your time on? What do you spend your money on? Once you've spent some time casting your mind over your life, we want to ask you to divide those things into these two columns. In the first column, we want you to write down all those things that you identify that give you life, that invigorate you, that you really enjoy doing, that leave you with a feeling of hope, love, charity, or faith. Those times, put simply, that you're tuning into God. Those times that if you put a stethoscope against them, you'd hear a loud, glorious Alleluia. In the other column, we want you to write down the opposite. Those things you identify that leave you with a feeling of disappointment, anger, sadness, that leave you feeling depressed or down, lethargic. Those times, in other words, put simply, that we start tuning in to other things, other noises. What's most important for this exercise is that you're honest. You're honest with yourself and you're honest with God. Just ask Him to help you take a long, clear look at your life so that you can start to identify those times when we're listening to Him and following the directions that He is leading us on, or those times when we're following other directions. So, once you're ready to begin, just press pause on the video and press play again when you want to come back. Welcome back. At this moment, if you're doing the retreat with other people, either in the room or on your computer, you might want to talk to them about that last exercise. You don't have to reveal any personal information, but sharing our feelings can have a really powerful effect. If you're doing this on your own, then now would be the time to reflect over the activity and note down any feelings or thoughts that you have. Here are some questions to help you. 1. How easy was it to separate your life into two columns? And what were the challenges of this exercise? too. Are you aware of specific feelings or emotions attached to the activities in each column? 3. Did you notice a pattern in your behaviour? Times when you were drawn to activities that pulled you closer to God, and times when you were drawn to the opposite. A pattern in those times when you tried to move towards God and moved away from Him. We suggest 10 minutes for this reflection discussion. So once again, pause the video, and when you're ready to begin, just press play. What we've just undertaken is a simple exercise in what St. Ignatius termed discernment of spirits. This is when we actively ask God to show us those moments when we draw close to Him and the counter movements that draw us away from Him. To draw this episode to a close, we're going to lead you in a meditation that is once again designed to help us become familiar with moments in our life when we were turning towards God and moments when we were turning away from Him. Most importantly, what we want to leave you with at the end of this episode is an impression of what those kind of moments feel like, so that going forward, you can start to become more familiar with those times when you're close to God and those times when you're further away from Him. So before we begin the meditation, become comfortable where you are. Sit still, breathe in and breathe out. Start to become aware of God's gaze upon you in this moment. How is He looking at you? How does His gaze make you feel? Look back at God, looking at you. And so let us begin our meditation. Think of a time when God felt distant or absent in your life. Where were you? Let's start with the temperature. Was it warm or cold? Was it a sunny or a cloudy day? What was the place like for you? Was it spacious or crowded? Were you on your own or in a group? Who were you with? And what were you doing? What was the memory like? How does it feel when you can't feel God? Perhaps you might like to write down some words, or just register how you feel. Now think of a time when you felt God present in your life. You felt His gaze upon you. Where were you? Once again, let's start with the temperature of the place. Was it hot or cold? Was it a sunny or a cloudy day? What was the place like for you? Was it spacious? Crowded? Were you on your own or in a group? Who were you with? And what were you doing? What was the memory like? How do you feel when you can feel God's presence? Perhaps you might like to write down how you feel, or just register. We will finish by listening to a hymn that was written by St. John Henry Newman while he was on a sea journey, looking for light and direction. Let the music wash over you, and let the words settle in your soul.
We are the light of the world. We are the light of the world.
Let us pray. Good Lord, we ask that you help us open our senses to you in our life. Give us the grace to know and feel when we move towards you and when we move away from you. Create in us the desire to always seek your face. We make this prayer through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.